Hey guys, so today I want to introduce you to our brand new Art Spotlight series. I want to make sure we're always pumping out more content for you, so we're starting to make different series for different parts of the team and what they're building and how they do it. It's getting pretty big at this point. We have over 60 people working on it, and they're all making pretty cool stuff, so I kind of want to show you what the art team's up to, how it is that they build what they build, and I hope that you guys enjoy. If you have any feedback, let us know.
Hey, today I'm going to talk about the creation of the character Mac. Our challenge was to do an alchemist character like this, going to be educated. He's going to be really smart. So this is our reference board. Basically, the artist who did it, he gathered different pieces from other artists, real life studies, even like listening to Middle Eastern music to create this character. We tried to do initial raw sketches to present different ideas here. Option one was like a really high society professor. We have here monocle, his very fancy mustache, potions, and this is like more of a king. Option two was a bit of a loner, basically. We tried to make him powerful. As you can see, bottles, scrolls, things that mostly about his knowledge. Option C was a bit younger guy, hiding from the society. I can see even like little scars on his hand because a lot of blood samples, maybe like very venomous plants or even like snakes, stuff like that. Right, option D is more like a druidic guy. The silhouette here is triangle and we hiding him in this shape. In contrast, you can see option, for example, option two has upside down triangle. It's a like more powerful male triangle, and here we are hiding him in a hood so the silhouette is obscured. On every option, we're trying to keep his clothing really beautiful, tailored. We wanted to make to look like he's achieved a lot and know his value. But all of the sketches, we have different poses, different design, different portrait. After discussion of the sketches, we can combine different things together to get a result that we need. Everybody loved option B. This is a black and white option. It's a version that we trying to polish the previous sketch to bring up the details, again in the shape of snakes. This is a crucial point when the picture is getting better and we're trying to see if it's going in the right direction. After this, we did the color. Initially, we know that the main palette of this character is going to be green, but we didn't know which complementary color is going to be for him. For example, option one, we had silvers, like bronze, and silver is not as rich for him, and we were thinking that we should make him a bit more wealthy by his looks. So option two had golden sleeves, golden marks. Option three was a bit darker. He provided a very mysterious look, like a cat in the night. It's very strong color palette, but the issue is here that we did not want to make him evil. Option four was very vibrant. It's not fitting to the character who's going to be educated as a professor. So option five, it was a really strong one, but we did not want to have Violet. At this point, he looks too much like a Joker. So we ended up with option two. So we proceeded to finalizing the character, adding the details, adding a lot of values and overall shading the character. So this is final look of the Mac. And yeah, you can see him in the Bazaar family. In contrast with other characters, it fits very well. All right, and also we did a few skins. We had a lot of options, but for this first initial skin, we really wanted to keep it in a color palette of the character and so that every skin is recognizable as Mac. We really wanted like our first skin to be dynamic and impactful. So these are more dynamic, more powerful stances. You can see his legs in a wide stance. His hands are really tense. You can see muscle. Here we have asymmetry, which is a really good tool, but asymmetry simplifies the image because when you read one part of it, you already know what the second part is going to be. And we wanted to keep the dynamics here. Option one creates much more dynamic, much more unique silhouette from the side to the color. What we try to do on those sketches is to add more detail. We experimented with the objects in his hand and really liked Philosopher's Stone on option two. It's one of our objects in the game player could buy and use as a mech. Expression is really important because this is going to be like 90% of the portrait that we are going to see in the game. So we picked option 2 and started working on it. This is what we get at the end, and you can see it in comparison with the original skin of the original mech. I hope you liked seeing the process of creating our hero character mech.